here comes the ice.
Is it floating?
Yeah. Or it was from this a little bit.
It's almost displacing you.
It's like going down and down and farther down.
Yeah.
Just gotta
show how to
melt the bracket.
Scoot this thing around for me.
Sure. What am I scooting, babe?
You're scooting the
chuck?
The chuck, yeah. I'm gonna try and line up the hole.
Okay, 20 minutes later, and we got the bit to where it knows where it is here and here. It's properly set. We move it to the other side, you know, based on the computer, it says it's correct there too. And what that has to do with, you got to measure where the bit actually is. You write that measurement down, and then you move it on the computer screen to where it should be, and then you take that measurement, you move it back to where it was, and you can change this number to say, oh, that really is this location. And you can confirm it by moving the bit to the other side of the material. And yeah, it's a pain in the ass, but we know that now this bit knows exactly, you know, the computer knows exactly where the edges of this are. They have little fancy gadgets that will come over and touch it and tell the computer that, oh, I'm there, but we don't have a little fancy gadget. So we take 20 minutes of our time to do this. And we put a little tape around this to keep it from scoring, hopefully. And now we're gonna set zero on the to the top of it, just a little bit below. And we're ready to cut.
100,000, 105,000 down.
Yeah.
So we're only taking 30,000. That'll make sure that when we get to the lathe, we cut it off flush and still have plenty of material.
Yeah. Oh, I see what it's doing.
I generated two patterns together.
Ooh, that'd be bad, maybe.
I just got both of them. Yeah.
This thing gives us the ability to look at the actual part, and we were looking at it like this, which kind of makes sense.
Until we
but
do
not
that.
Really. Oh, that's even stupid. That's why we were finding the outside of the part here, because this part actually does go to the outside.
Yeah.
This is two parts generated together, and they shouldn't be. We'll do it
right.
We'll do it right and show you what the difference is. It'll make a lot of sense. See, I actually printed this piece of dome top with it, and that's the last cut.
Oh, but we don't have to.
What I gotta do is I gotta come up here. This is the piece I want. So see, that's what I'm cutting. I'm cutting two pieces that don't make any sense at all. And see, it's kind of confusing because this is Bob CAD. And it takes a while to get how to figure it out, but you can blank out the piece, but it will still generate the code for it. You have to also come over here and say, I want to post yes, no, so that it's X'd out, so that it's not gonna post it. That's what we want right there. You ready to go eat? Where do you want to go eat?
If not, we're going to go to Monterey's.
Monterey, she said. Okay, there we go. Generated new G code from Bob CAD, and that's what we want to see. So that was a rough cut. This next one is going to be the finish cut down in the bottom of it, and then we'll come back and do the straight up sides on it, because it's got an inch of it that's just straight. Well, pipe essentially, look at me. There you go. There in the middle, there's a little indentation that shouldn't be there. It's like it got a flat spot and then a ridge on it. It might be able to be buffed out, but I doubt it. That's pretty big. Right there's the mistake on the pattern too. It's there. It's got the stupid lines that are a little farther down.
Cut it a little lower. We got a little extra material. Deeper.
Yeah.
We have 60,000 left. Okay, after another 2 hours of farting around with Bob CAD, which I'm not crazy about their software, I generated a code that cuts from the outside in, and it got rid of the little dimple that it had in the bottom. There you are. See that? Right in the center, it's flat.
Yeah.
Said one wall looked thicker than the other.
It is. Okay.
We either didn't center it up right, or the machine's calibration is out and it cut one thinner than the other.
Well.
And you know the X or the Y axis.
Well, it is much smoother though.
Yeah, it's doing a good job. That's at 600 right there. So this is 1200, and that's the next one's going to be 2000, and then we go to paste.
So we've gone up to 2000 grit. Of sandpaper on the inside of the dome here. I'm getting ready to switch out to a paste, and it's Novus number 2 for fine scratch remover. And we learned about this from Ben Krasnow.
Yeah, let me show you his webpage. He's got all kinds of good scientific stuff on there, and that's the guy. And subscribe to him. He's got good information on polishing acrylic and other things, thousands of which I'll never need, but this one came in very handy.
It's kind of like car polish. You put it on in a circular motion, and you're going to let it dry.
Oh, it's like car wax.
Yeah, it is. It's just like car wax.
So we don't use the lathe?
No, you don't have to.
So we could do this after the fact.
Right. And then we'll use one of these heads, and we'll kind of start off with the harder ones and progress down to the softest ones.
They're used for buffing it out?
Yeah, they're used only for buffing it out. So
you don't apply the stuff with them?
No, don't apply it with these. And then, so like this is for the sides that are straight. And then these are for the dome part, the spherical area of it.
And we got these off eBay, I think. They're called buffing cones.
Buffing cones.
And they were just a set.
And all they are is a muslin cloth, layers of it. So it's not, what do you call it? Cami cloth, chamois.
Chamois or anything.
Chamois,
no. Fancy is just a real
soft. So it'll
real
rinse
soft.
Out. Right, and it'll rinse out easily.
They make them in harder layers too, but those are for harsher cutting. There's some good videos on YouTube University about how to do this for, you know, polishing headlights and that kind of stuff on cars.
Right.
But it's been good information.
Well, all we were going to do is I was going to turn on the lathe.
And hold one of those in there?
Hold one of those in there.
That'll work.
And buff it out.
Good.
So this is after my second buffing. I also did the outside. And you can see that it's really clear. So I don't think we're going to have any problem getting our domes as far as clarity down. We'll get that.
Calibrated it and we changed
very little.
Nothing. Very little. Probably nothing. We just don't think the machine will do any better than 20 thousandths on a It's just going to have a bunch of air in it.
We only changed 7 thousandths.
Yeah.
So we didn't change what it could actually
cut. So we've recalibrated it. We don't think it's that, it was off. We don't think the machine can do that accurate, but that was way, it was off too much for calibration error. So we don't know. So what we've done, we've set it up again. We've started from the center point this time.
And we're getting rid
of it. And we changed the jaws of the round on the chuck. So now the jaws are reversed so that the bit won't run into the jaw. We've figured out the bit's going to come down just a little bit below the tape here, but it won't hit the jaw. And so we're ready to try a rough cut. Cross the fingers. It is so cool to be able to go eat dinner while some machine does your work for you.
Well, that came out good.
Yeah, I think so too. It didn't look, does it look like it's out of center?
You know, I couldn't tell last time.
It looks like it might be a little more on this side than on this one. I'm gonna have to figure out a way to get that
right. Yeah, I do. I think you're right.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah. It is what it is, because we're not changing it now.
No, especially on this one. But it would be nice for us to figure out how to improve that.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the final cut, and it's just that dome thing. But we actually had to go in, and right here at the top of the dome, we had to actually modify the G-code manually to get it actually rounded right in here. Because the Bobcad, when it output the G-code, had flattened out. So we're learning that Bobcat doesn't do domes very well. Good friend there.
Friend of me.
Just stuck on there.
Oh.
So there it is. We could polish it more, but
We aren't going to.
It doesn't matter, because what we're going to do is this unit has, you know, we obviously have some flaws, and it's too thin here, it's too thick here, it was off, there's a bump, there's a dimple. Yeah. But what we're going to do with it that we really care about is we're going to see if it implodes. If it implodes, then if it doesn't, then hey, maybe we'll polish it up some more.
Till then, we're not.
Yeah.